Hello, friends. In today's episode of Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform, we're going to unravel the complexities of regular expressions, or RegEx for short. RegEx is a pretty powerful tool for pattern matching and text manipulation, and once you get the hang of it, you'll be able to perform some truly magical operations on strings. Let's get pattern matching. Okay. Regular expressions are sequences of characters that form a search pattern. They can be used for validating text, they can be used for performing replacements, or extracting information from strings. JavaScript has regex expressions and objects built into its engine for you to use in all of your scripting needs. So let's start creating a pattern. So let's say our word pattern is the word magic. We want to look for the word magic inside of another string. To create a regular expression, you surround it by slashes like this. There you go. I just created a pattern for reg expressions. Now let's see if we can try to find that pattern inside of another string. So I'm going to go ahead and create a test string, and I'm going to say the magic of regex starts here. So as we can see, we do see that the word magic appears in there. And now we want to see if we can find it. So let's go ahead and do a console log, and does the word match? And to do that test, it's built into JavaScript. All you have to say is word pattern, which is our regular expression variable, and then test for that string. So we're basically saying here, using this pattern, the slash magic slash, let's test it on the string and let's see what happens. True, it does. The dot test method does return true or false, depending on if it's there or not. Let's kind of demonstrate that even further. I'm gonna break that string up and then run that test again, and now it's false. So let's keep exploring. Regular expressions aren't restricted to just letters. It's actually a lot more powerful because you can use special characters, and let me kind of demonstrate that right now. So let's say we want to look for any numerical digits inside of a string. There's no button on my keyboard that says any possible numerical digit. And so baked into regular expressions are these special characters. And a lot of them can be looked up on Google or at any available reg expression websites, and I'll include some of those in the description to help you learn more regular expressions, but I'll be showing you some of them right now. So to find any numerical digit, you use a backslash and then press D. So this backslash D denotes what I'm trying to look for. It basically says any digit. So let's go ahead and test that. So if I have a string with numbers in it, let's say ServiceNow 2023. Let's go ahead and do that test now. So I have a console log, and is there a digit in here? We're gonna say digit pattern dot test, and we're gonna test it on our string with numbers. Let's see what happens. There is a digit inside of that string, and it found it, and now it's returning true. Let's use the same concept that we have, but let's say we're looking for specifically a string that has four digits right next to each other. To denote that in a regular expression, you use curly brackets and you tell it a number inside that curly brackets to say how many of those characters are you looking for. And so if I were to read this in regex speak, this is basically saying, find me any string of four digits. That's what that's saying. And so if I press run script really quick, let me match this really quick. Four digits. And I run it. It's true. Now let's change it to only three digits. False. So it's specifically looking for strings that are four digits long. Okay, let's kind of put the pedal to the metal and get really complex, because regex allows for some really complex patterns. And if you look at this, I'm wondering how many of you actually know what this is looking for from the top of your head. If you did know, let me know in the comments and I'll give you a little thumbs up for knowing what this is checking for from the top of your head. Because I don't even know what that is from the top of my head. I have to Google it whenever I look at, when I see something like this. But what this is doing, it's actually looking for emails. So to read this, I'm actually going to go ahead and copy it and paste it into one of my favorite regex websites, regexer.com. And I'm going to put it inside of the expression. So there it is. And now I can read what it is here. So basically, it's looking for not a white space, and it needs to have at least one or more characters there, the actual at symbol. And then again, any non-white space, so any character, digit, or special characters in that case. And it has to have more than one of them, a dot, and then again, not white space, and it has to have more than one of them. So if we test it here, we can actually see that this isn't working. But if I put in my email address, it does recreate a match. And if I want to go bare bones and test it from the very minimum that it'll need, a at b dot c is also something that works. But it's looking basically for letters or some character before an at symbol, then more characters, the dot, and then more characters. And that's that regex. I know emails get a lot more complex than that, but for this case, this is a pretty simplified regular expression to find email addresses. And to demonstrate it in ServiceNow, I have these tests that I'm just going to paste from the lesson examples. And we'll see that if we test it against this string, it should return true. And if we test it against this string, which is missing the dot, it should return false. And there it goes. And one really quick method I want to teach you about is dot replace, because it's a pretty powerful way to manipulate your strings using regular expressions. So let's pretend we have a pattern that's looking for the letters SN next to each other. And then I'm going to add this G at the end of it, because what that means is I want it to look globally. So not just the first instance of SN, but all the instances of this pattern that might appear in a string. And let's pretend we have this string called SN is awesome, SN rocks. And then we're gonna take that and we're gonna make a new string, and it's gonna be based off of the replace string. And we're gonna replace all instances of that pattern with ServiceNow spelled out. So let's walk through this really quick again. We have a pattern of looking for anything that says SN next to each other. We have a string that we want to manipulate, and then we're going to create a new string using this dot replace method. So we're going to take the string, we're going to dot replace it because it's built into strings, and we're going to give it the pattern as a first parameter, and then we're going to say what we want to replace it with. A string of ServiceNow. Let's see what happens. We're going to say log replaced string, and we're going to ask for the new string. And let's run it. There you go. It took the old string where it only said SN and replaced it with ServiceNow. So you can see why it's so useful to know regular expressions, because you can make it very simple, like a string replacement, a text replacement. But if you need to be much more complex with, are there digits? Are there white spaces? Are there new line characters? You can replace, you can find, you can match them. You can do all these different things using regular expressions. Honestly, regex can have hours of content to teach you, but these are some basics for you. I encourage you to dive into some regex resources or libraries, or cheat sheets is another way to look it up. And you, honestly, most people will just Google it when they need a regular expression or a specific one, because a lot of people probably have already figured out how to make those patterns for you. So take a look at it. Try the exercise next, because it's an interesting one, and we'll see you soon.